Ready? Now I'm going to tell you basics of using an oscilloscope and a DC power supply unit. This is a Tektronix TBS112B digital oscilloscope. So it has a sampling frequency of 2 giga samples per second. So it samples the signal at a very high rate. Now, this is a two-channel oscilloscope. What this means is that there are two probes connected to the oscilloscope. Now, in order to learn about the usage and what this two probe means, let me turn it on. The power button is on the top. So I press this, the green light turns on and it starts to load. Now, in order to learn the use of an oscilloscope, I'm also going to use a DC power supply unit. This on the side over here is a DC power supply unit. I'm going to turn it on. It is a DC 3005 power supply unit. This is also a two-channel supply unit. So what this means is that we can get two channels where the voltage can be varied from 0 to 30 volts independently, and the DC supply can be used either in constant voltage mode, so which basically reads as CV, or you can use it in constant current mode or the CC mode. So I'll show you how to do both. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this DC supply and I'm going to connect it across the oscilloscope. So this is how the probe of an oscilloscope looks. So you have a hook end for one of them. So this needs to be connected to the higher voltage, and you have an alligator clip. The alligator clip needs to be connected to the ground of the supply. So here I take the hook and I connect it to the high voltage side of the supply unit, and then I take the alligator clip and I connect it across the ground of the supply unit. Now, right now, I have set the voltage at 4.8 volt. So let us see what is happening in the oscilloscope. So in the oscilloscope, the supply has been connected to the yellow colored channel. The channels are color coded. So you have a yellow colored line and a blue colored line. So here, so in terms of the signal, the yellow colored signal is this and the blue colored signal is this. Now, in order to see what is happening really, you need to pay attention to whatever is being displayed at the bottom of the oscilloscope. So for the yellow colored line, you can see that vertically each box corresponds to 2 volts. And horizontally, right now, the width of the box corresponds to 500 microseconds. So what I'm going to do is get this to 1 second. So for that, we are going to use these dials. So a little bit about the dials. So these two dials are going to alter how we visualize the yellow colored signal in the vertical direction. These two dials correspond to how we visualize the signal for the blue colored signal in the vertical direction, and these two dials alter the time scale aspect of the signal. So let's see. So in order to change the time scale, so right now the width of each box is 500 microseconds. In order to change it to 1 second, I have to rotate the scale option here. So I am rotating it. So now you can see this particular value changing over here. So right now it's 1 millisecond. As I turn the dial to the left in anti-clockwise direction, this is increasing. So I'm going to take this to 1 second. Okay, so right now the horizontal line corresponds to 1 second. So now over here for the DC supply, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this knob to the right and then to the left. Basically, I am going to play around with the signal. So what this does is this is going to change things on the oscilloscope reading. So first let me change the scaling. Vertically each box has a height of 2 volts, so I'm going to change that to 5 volts. Okay, so now as I change the signal on the DC supply unit, you can see it changing over here. And in order to see what is the range of the voltage that I have been changing around, so what I can do is I can press on this run or stop, that freezes the screen. Now I'll tell you how to read what is happening. So the height of each box is 5 volt, so you can see that the voltage in the DC supply was varied from about 5 volt to about 16 volts. Remember, height of each box is 5 volt. And in what time duration did this change happen? So you can see each box is 1 second width. So over here the trough to trough is approximately 2 seconds. So the frequency of the signal over here is approximately 0.5 hertz. This was done manually, so this is not a perfect sinusoidal signal, but you get the idea. In order to shift the signal horizontally, you can use this knob here. So as I use this knob, the signal shifts horizontally. So you can see it shifting. So I have shifted it such that the trough is initially along the y-axis. And now you can see what is happening. And in order to do some measurements of the signal, what you can do is you can press on the measure button over here. So you can see measure. If I press on measure, then this comes up. Then I press on channel 1, which is what is the yellow signal. Now, in order to select what I want to measure, I just press this big dial here. I press it once. So now period is being measured. Then I press on frequency. Now frequency will be measured. Then peak to peak, minimum, maximum. Okay. So already certain items were selected. You can do a selection of a maximum of 6 parameters. Okay. So I go to channel 2. I'll unclick on what was initially selected. So then it will give me more options for channel 1. Now I go back to channel 1. This time I can do more, maximum, minimum, and I can even measure, let's say, RMS. Okay. Alright. So now all of these parameters are visible over here. So if I go to run the signal, now if I am going to vary this thing, this is not a perfect sinusoidal signal, so maybe because of that it is unable to do this maximum to maximum and all that. All right so now in order to get these things correctly, what I'm going to do is, instead of connecting the oscilloscope probe to the DC supply unit, I'm going to connect it across a 1 kilohertz signal which the oscilloscope itself provides. So I connect the positive probe over here and I connect the ground to the ground pin here. Now I'm going to run this thing. So now you can see that the signal is actually a square pulse, and I'm going to use an auto set option. So the auto set will automatically decide what should be the voltage and what should be the this thing. I think the auto set has removed the features corresponding to the probe one. Now I would like you to sort of pay attention to a bunch of things here. You can see the yellow colored signal and the blue colored signal. The blue colored signal is actually coming from a open probe, meaning it has not been connected to anything. So then what is it that it is measuring exactly over here? So what is happening is that this blue colored signal wire is actually working as an antenna, and it is picking up the electromagnetic field caused by the AC current passing through the lines. So if I'm going to freeze this, you can check the time period of this particular signal. So let me move this time axis such that the trough is on the y-axis, and then you can check that the horizontal scale right now is 10 milliseconds. So the time period of the signal for the blue signal
is actually 20 milliseconds or 50 hertz. So this corresponds to the voltage we are picking from the electromagnetic field present in the air around us. Now let's pay attention. Let's see what's happening to the yellow colored signal. So for that, I'll press on this blue colored button. So this is like a toggle switch. So once I press on this blue colored button, now the blue colored signal is gone and I only have the yellow colored signal from probe 1. So now what I'll do is I'll just sort of center the signal. So for that I'll use this second probe here. Okay, so its signal is now centered. Now I'll change this time axis such that we can see the signal better. Okay, and then I'm going to arrest it. So now you come here and then read the signal, what is happening. So the maximum value of the signal is 5.4 volts, peak to peak is 5.6, time period is close to 1 millisecond or it's a 1000 hertz signal. You can check the frequency of the signal here, 1.007 kilohertz. Minimum value is minus 200 millivolt. RMS of the signal is close to 3.8 volts. So this is how you can read use a oscilloscope. So you can visualize the voltage signals and you can visualize two voltage signals at one point of time. So in order to understand the usage, I want you to connect one channel of the DC supply unit to one channel of the oscilloscope and then change the voltage on the DC supply and visualize the voltage change on the oscilloscope. Now let's come back to the DC supply unit. Now in the DC supply unit, you can see there are two channels, right? I have been using this channel number 2 under the constant voltage mode. In order to trigger the constant current mode, we need to connect it across something which has a low resistance. So I am doing the following over here. So I have a copper coil. The copper coil is normally enamel coated, so it is insulated. In order to check whether this is insulated or not, what can we do? We go back to the multimeter. So again, I go to the multimeter, I turn it on, and then put it in the continuity check mode. And then I just connect it across any two points. So you can see it is not beeping, meaning this is insulated, it's not continuous. Now, in order to get some electrical connection, you have to use a sandpaper, sand off the two ends, and once you sand it off, then you will get a continuity. Now check. Okay, so now you can hear the beep sound, so it's continuous now. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take this channel that I have, I'll take the red colored wire. Okay, first let me turn it off. I'll take the red colored wire, connect it to one end of this coil that I have here. You can use alligator clips also. For now, I'm just twisting and connecting the wire. The second end, I'm going to connect it to the ground of the DC supply unit. Okay. Then I'm going to turn on the weighing scale here. So this reads as zero. So whatever is there on this system is zero. So if I'm going to lift it, it will read a negative value, minus 17 grams. If I am going to apply a downward force, it will show a positive reading. Okay. So let's again go to tear. So it reads 0, 0. Now I'm going to turn on the supply. So now since the resistance of this coil is small, it will automatically go to a constant current mode, and right now the current is 0.11 ampere. I'm going to increase the current in the system. So for that, I have to turn this knob. So currently 1 amp is flowing through. Now 2 amperes of current is flowing through. Now, when the current flows through this particular coil, this is going to act like an electromagnet. And now, if I am going to take any iron item and if I am going to put it into the coil, you will see, check the reading over here. You will see that a negative
2 grams odd force is showing up. So it's working like an electromagnet and it is getting attracted to iron, because of which the weight is going on the negative side. Okay, all right. So this is in the in order to activate the constant current mode, you have to take something with a very low resistance, and then by rotating this particular dial over here, you can increase the current. You can go to a maximum of 5 amperes. So this 3005 stands for 30 is the voltage, maximum voltage that you can get. 5 is the maximum amperes of the current that you can get from the DC power supply unit. So right now 5 amps is coming. Once 5 amps flows through this, this starts to get heated up. So right now it is just mildly hot. It's safe to touch it. Voltage is very low, 5 volts, just like a battery. But it's starting to get hot quickly now. And the electromagnetic effect will also be higher now. So if I put this inside, so you can see now the force reading is close to 10 grams. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.